से दैट इज पब्लिक के एल्गोरिदम मायसेल्फ रश्मि दीक्षित. सो लर्निंग आउटकम एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन पब्लिक की रिक्वायरमेंट्स. दे आर ऑल्सो एबल टू एक्सप्लेन वॉट इज आर एस ए एंड वॉट आर द स्टेप्स ऑफ आर एस ए एंड बिकॉज ऑफ विच दे आर एबल टू जनरेट पेयर ऑफ कीज यूजिंग आर एस ए अल्गोरिथम. सो फर्स्ट वी विल चेक आउट वॉट आर पब्लिक की रिक्वायरमेंट्स. पब्लिक के अल्गोरिदम्स रिलाई ऑन टू कीज वेयर इट इज कंपल्सरी ऑफ हैविंग कंप्यूटेशनली इनफिजिबिलिटी एंड कंप्यूटेशनली ईजीनेस. सो वॉट इज अ मीन्स ऑफ कंप्यूटेशनली इनफिजिबल. इट इज कंप्यूटेशनली इनफिजिबल टू फाइंड डिक्रिप्शन की बाय नोइंग ओनली अल्गोरिदम एंड इनक्रिप्शन की. एंड वॉट इज कंप्यूटेशनली ईजी. इट इज कंप्यूटेशनली ईजी टू एनक्रिप्ट और डिक्रिप्ट मैसेज व्हेन रिलेवेंट कीज आर नो. सो आइदर ऑफ द टू रिलेटेड कीज कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर एनक्रिप्शन विद द अदर यूज्ड फॉर डिक्रिप्शन यूजिंग द सम अल्गोरिदम एंड दीज आर फॉरबिडन रिक्वायरमेंट्स विच ओनली अ फ्यू अल्गोरिदम्स हैव सेटिस्फाइड. सो वी हैव सीन what are public key requirements. Now we will look out the two more definitions how the security of public key schemes have defined. So it needs a trapdoor one way function. Now what is one way function or what is a characteristic of a one way function? Y is a function of x we can called as easy and it is not possible to find out x by getting or by applying a inverse of function on a y. It is somewhat or it is infeasible to get x by applying inverse function on a y. It is called as one way function. Now the next definition is trapdoor one way function. Now what is that? Y by applying function on a x is easy if k and x are known. X by applying inverse function on a y is easy if k and y are known, but x by applying inverse function on a y is infeasible if y is known but k is not known. A practical public key scheme depends on a suitable trapdoor one way function. So it is not possible to get original message by applying reverse function on a cipher text, no matter either algorithm is known or key is known. So what are the public key requirements? Like private key schemes, brute force exhaustive search attack is always theoretically possible, but the keys used are too large, which is greater than 512 bits. Security relies on a large enough differences in a difficulty between easy and hard. The third one is, more generally, the hard problem is known but is made hard enough to be impractical to break. Problem knowing is different than problem breaking, and it requires the use of very large numbers, hence is slow compared to private key schemes. Now RSA, it is an algorithm by three scientists, Rivest, Shamir and Adelman of MIT, which is built in a year of 1977. It is best known and widely used public key scheme or public key algorithm. It is based on exponential in a finite or Galois field over integers modulo a prime. Here it is a characteristic of RSA. It is based on modulo a prime. NB, exponential takes on an average big O of log n to the cubical operations. It uses large integers up to 1024 bits, and provide security due to cost of factoring large numbers. NB, factorization takes big of e raised to log n log n log n operation, which is hard. Now, what is the use of RSA encryption, or how it decryption, or how it is built? To encrypt the message M, the sender obtain a public key of a receiver, that is public key, two public keys E and N, then compute, that is ciphertext, M raised to E mod N, where M is between 0 to N. And to decrypt a ciphertext C, the owner uses its own private key, which is defined as a PR, D and N, and computes, that is message from the ciphertext C raised to D mod N. Now note that the message M must be smaller than the modulus of N. That is important point. Now these are the steps of RSA. How to generate RSA key, that is a public key and private key, EN and DN. So E and D. So each user generates a public and private key pair by, it is purely a mathematical. So start with a selecting two large prime numbers, let us say as a P and Q, then computing their system modulus by taking the multiplication and then taking the mod, that is P minus 1, Q minus 1, up to that. Then selecting at random the encryption key E. Now what is the rule for that E? It is between 1 and mod of N, that is 1, and the second one is GCD, that is a greatest common divisor, will give you only 1, that is a common between E and phi of N is compulsory 1, means there should not be common between E and phi of N. And then ED is equal to 1 mod phi of N. That is a formula to find out the decryption key, and D is between 0 to N. After that, the publish their public encryption keys PU, E and N, and keep secret private decryption key, that is D and N. How you can say that RSA will work finely, or it will always give you good result? Because it has a characteristic of a Euler's theorem. A of phi of n mod n is equal to 1, where GCD between these two is 1. That is an important characteristic. RSA, by finding n, by applying mod of n, and then choosing carefully E and D, such that it will try to give 100% security. CD is equal to MED, where M is equal to 1 plus K multiplied by mod of N. And M1, and by applying 1 raised to K on that M, we will get M raised M mod N. And in this mathematical formula, the security of RSA. Now just we will sort out, or we will look out the one example. In the next session, we will solve the example. Now select primes. We will just chosen randomly P17, Q11. Remember one thing, for a calculation, we have chosen two digit number. Numbers are so large, or nowadays just think numbers might be anything. Now we are calculating N, that is PQ, by taking the multiplication of 17 and 11, that is 187. Then we are going to calculate the phi of N, or modulus of N, P minus 1 multiplied by Q minus 1, that is 16 into 10, 160. Now it is a time to select E. It depends on a GCD E, and phi of N should be 1. So you can choose any. Here I have taken E is equal to 7. Now it is a time to determine D. So what is our formula? DE, that is a multiplication of DE, is equal to 1 mod N. 1 mod, not N, phi of N, sorry. So phi of N. So 1 mod 160 and value of D should be less than 160. So by taking calculations, here I find out D is 23. Why? You can also try to find out D 23 into 7, that is 161. So 161, 10 into 160 plus 1 gives you 1. And now it's time to publish public key, that is 7 and 187, that is E and N, N is 187, by calculating P multiply by Q, and keep secret private key. Now what is private key? Again, D and N. So by calculation, D is 23,187. So that key will be private. Now student, please pause the video and try to figure out the answer. What is the question? In RSA, we select a value E such that it is in between 0 and phi of N and it is relatively prime to phi of N. Just look at the, or just try to recall the algorithm, you will get the answer. Is it true or false? What is? It is false. We select, what is the question? We select a value E such that it lies between 0 and phi of N and it is relatively prime to phi of N. So how do we are going to find E? We are taking the GCD of E and phi of N, and after that we are going to choose the E. So this is false. So this is the reference. Thank you.